Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. In this tutorial series, I will show you how you can take, save, and of course, upload and download your images from Firebase's Firebase storage. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let me just show you what we are going to build out. And this is a real simple app. So let's just select iPhone 10 here. And you want to click the link down below to get the resources. And we will construct the app from scratch from those resources. But for now, let's just take a look at what this app basically looks like. Okay, so not a big stuff here, only four buttons, and these are tab bar items, a take, a save, a download, and an upload. And this grayish background is basically the background of a UI image view that is stretched all the way on the screen. So that is what we are going to build out today. Please do go ahead and click the link down below for getting the resources. And when you do, you will see that we have a custom album, error plus, pot file, and a root view controller. Now, let's just start off from the beginning and we will see what we are going to build out. So what we want to do is go ahead and click on File, New, and Project. Okay, it will be a single view application, and I will choose my very own custom template, and I will name this, okay, I will embed it in a navigation controller, because yes, that's what I want to have, navigation, so I can basically add in there some navigation tab bar items. Okay, let's click on Next. And let's just add it here, and I will create a Git repository so you can take a look at the finished project. Well, there will be some milestones that you will see, but basically you can get this link from the resources on my site. So let's click on create here. There we go. First off, let's just simply add in our pod file. So let's close this and let's open up terminal here, type in cd and a space, and go to your root folder of the project, hit return, type in pod init to create the pod file. And now let's go to our resources and open up our pod file that I have provided. And you will see that there are four pods there. So copy and paste those and open up the created pod file and paste that in there. Oh, sorry. Let's just move that to the icon and let's paste that in there. So basically we are using tiny constraints to constrain our views, Firebase storage to store our image later on the series, and Firebase Firestore to store the data, well, basically the image URL in the Firebase Firestore's database, and Kingfisher to basically just fetch that image from that URL. Okay, let's close this, and what we want to do now is install these. So pod install is the command line that we want to add, and let's just wait for everything to install correctly, and you should see a message that we are ready. So please close any current Xcode sessions and use Xcode workspace from now on. Okay, let's do that. So Swift Image Mania, here we go. Now in this first video, I am just simply going to teach you how you can save to your photo library. So let's just set up our app for that. And what we need to do is basically delete this root view controller and add in the one that I have provided. Or rather that I will not delete it. I will just simply copy and paste the contents of that root view controller. So let's just open it up, select all with command A and copy it with command C, close that off, and let's just paste all of that in. There we go. Okay, now let's just hit command B so we can see that everything works, and I will guide you through this setup of our root view controller, and hopefully it will run. First of all, we have some keys that I'm using throughout the code, like the images folder key and the collection. This is for Firebase. UID and image URL is for the storing of these data in a Firestore. And yeah, this is a good way of using constants because these are always typo sensitive. Okay, let's go and take a look at our root view controller. We have four UI bar bottom items: take photo, save photo, upload photo, and download photo. And for those, we have these Objective-C file private functions that we will implement throughout this tutorial series. Next up, we have our image picker controller, because yeah, if I'm not going to talk about picking images with UI image picker controller, I have a separate video on that, so go ahead and take a look at it if you want to dive into these in more details. But basically, we are setting up our image picker controller. We are setting the delegate to self, and the source type will be camera. Go ahead and make sure that you do have your device ready for this test, and maybe plug it in, or if you would rather use it through your Wi-Fi, go ahead and take a look at how you can enable wireless debugging. I have a special video for that too. Finally, we have our image view that is set to the scale aspect fill, and it has a background of light gray and an activity indicator that is gray. Okay, that is basically it. We are setting up our navigation item. We are adding the bar bottom items here, left and right, and we are setting the views up. Basically, we are adding a background color of white. We are adding the image view and the activity indicator, and we are adding the image view to the super view with the help of tiny constraints, and our activity indicator is in the center of our super view. Now, as I told you, I'm not going to talk about taking photos. We are showing or presenting the image picker controller, and for that we are having our UI navigation controller delegate and UI image picker controller delegate in the extension. And what we are doing here is that if we do have a selected image, then we add that image to our image view and we dismiss the image picker controller. Of course, this is when we did finish picking media with info. Okay, one last thing, we will have this did finish saving with error function that we will use shortly, and a helper present alert that basically creates an alert controller and presents it. And while we are here, in some cases the activity indicator will be animating, so we are stopping that. Okay, so in this video we are going to save our photo to the library. So what do we have to do here? And as you can see, we are going to work only on these three. What we need is to go into the save photo function and add one single line of code, and that is how easy it is to save to your photo library. So let's add some code into the save photo function. Okay, and that is UI image write to save photos album image context info. So that is a long one, but let's see here. First, we want to add, or rather yet, guard let unwrap our image. So guard let image equals image view. image, as we just simply want to return, don't want to do anything if we don't get an image. So there we go, let's copy and paste that in and there. Next up we have our completion target, that is self, because we are going to use a completion selector, and that is hash selector. And if you recall, I have added in here an image did finish saving with error, so that is what we are going to use. So let's just start typing in image did finish saving with error. There we go, and that is quite okay there, and the context info will be nil. Okay, and that should take care of it. Let's hit command B so we can see that everything works as expected. Build has succeeded, great. Now before we run our app, because if we would run now the app would crash and we would have an error in the log, but it's not always that intuitive to figure out what's wrong. What we need to do is go into our info plist file and just select info under your target, and let's add some privacy keys. And there will be three for this app. So the first one is privacy and a space and a line, and it will be camera usage description. There we go. And for the value, let's add in here. The next one is a photo library usage description. So click on this plus button here. And again, privacy and a little line, a space and a line in space, and library usage description. Where it is? Where is it? So library usage description. There we go. So again, for the value. And while we are here, because we are going to save our photo to our photo library, we still need to add something else, like privacy and library, and there should be photo library additions. Let me just spell that out right for you. Photo library additions usage description. And that is what we need in order to be able to, or to be allowed to write to the user's photo library. This is not location usage description, sorry about that. We need to edit this because it's photo library usage description. So photo library usage description, there we go. Okay, and for the key for the photo library additions usage description, we will add this app wants to save photos to your photo library. So these are required by Apple. So you give an explanation why you want to use these private settings from your app. So what we are going to do now is basically, let's go back to our root view controllers. You may see this one line of code again, and let's build and run. Make sure you have selected your device, or you have plugged that in, and let's build and run. And you need a device because, yes, I am going to use the camera, and of course the simulator nor the Mac has a camera. So let's unlock this so we may see what we are up to here. So I'm having this QuickTime player, and first of all, let's take a photo. And as you can see, it says Swift Image Media would like to access the camera. This app wants to use your camera. Great, let's give it access by tapping OK. And now I will just simply snap a photo here. There we go. And I will use it. Okay, and as you can see, there it is. we have our photo populated in the UI view controller. Okay, now let's save this by clicking on the save button. And now it says this app wants to save photos to your photo library. Let's give access to that too. And it says image successfully saved, or image saved successfully. There we go. Okay, now let's double check if we did get that image saved. So let's take a look at our photos library here. There we go. Today. Great. Now that is it for this video tutorial, because I'm kind of running out of time. In the next one, we will take a look at how you can save an image, not to the default saved photos album, but to your very own photos album that, if you wanted to, you can create. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell as usual. And as always, I will see you in the next one.